In this video, I want to show you how, when using a standard normal distribution, how percentiles work. But before I do that, let's talk real quick and go over what a percentile means. When you see that word, percentile, I want you to think of these phrases, less than, or think of maybe the phrase below. If you are told that you scored, maybe on a standardized test like the SAT or the ACT, or, your IQ score, whatever it might be, that you are in the, let's say, 96th percentile, right? Let's say that you are in the 96th percentile. What does that mean? That means that 96% of the people who took that test, or 96% of the people who you're referring to, of all the in the entire distribution, is below your score, is less than your score. Okay, so the 96th percentile is kind of this picture going on here. Think of it this way. You are referring to a Z number, a Z score, where 96% is below yours. You also know that 96% is 0.96, right? Same thing. So let's say that 0 is sitting in the middle. We're referring to then a Z number that is somewhere over here, because 96% below yours is this picture going on. That means everything kind of shaded to the left of, right? 96% is all of this area shaded to the left of over here. So we're looking for, what is the z-score that corresponds to 96th percentile? Well, if I know that all of this area in here is 96 or 0.96, then I'll just look it up here on my table. Right? Again, I keep referring to this table in all my videos. So I'm looking up in this area here. I'm looking up for a 0.96, at least the thing that comes closest to it. And I know you can't read that my finger is pointing to, but it looks like the closest number that I get to 0.96 is 0.9599. Right? 0.9599. That's the closest value that I get as far as an area is concerned. So I'm just going to write that down, 0.9599. All right, very, very, very close. The closest thing I can find to 0.96. Now, what Z number corresponds to that? I get a Z number of 1.75, right? A Z number of 1.75 that corresponds to this 0.9599. So sometimes on my math lab or in your book, homework, it asks, what is the z-score that corresponds to a 96th percentile? Let's do one more percentile. How about, let's see, I'll make one up here. How about I'm looking for the z-score that corresponds to the 34th percentile, right? I'm looking for a z-score that corresponds to the 34th percentile. What does that mean? That means that 34% of the data, 34% of the scores are below yours. Now 34 is smaller, right? It's smaller than 1/2. It's smaller than 0.5. Okay, this is really 0.34. So since this number is smaller than 0.5, then we must be referring to, 0 sitting in the middle, we must be referring to some Z number over here, where again percentile means shaded below yours, that is a negative Z number, right? The negative Z number, because it's to the left of 0. So this area over here is 0.34. Well, I'll just look that up over here on my table of negative Z scores, right? Negative Z scores. And the value that comes closest to it, I know you probably can't see it, and so I'm just going to go hunt for it myself. The closest thing that I see to 0.34 is, let's see, where is that here? Right, the closest thing I'm getting is 0.3409. Hope you can see that on your table if you're using the Triola book. So 0.3409. That is the probability or area that comes closest to, that is the closest thing I can find to 0.34. All right, so, and that number there, 0.3409, corresponds to a z-score of negative 0.41. Negative 0.41. So in this case here, this z-score that corresponds to, or the closest thing to the 34th percentile, is negative 0.41. That's what I would enter in on my math lab or my homework assignment or whatever it might be. So I hope the percentile makes a little bit more sense to you now.